it's like 6:20 in the morning, and I just decided to start doing it again, making some bread. This time, I hate to change a bunch of variables, but this time it's going to be different again. This time I'm going to use the Claire Saffitz dessert person model for the most part, except I'm going to do a loaf and not like one of those round ones. I'm going to do the regular loaf pan. So this time I'm going to do 500 grams of flour and 350 grams of water, and mix those two together and let them sit. It's called an autolyse. And with that, you let it sit, and then we'll add the starter later. So I'm going to make this part. It's going to take a little bit. Then we add the starter later. So I literally make this and let it sit for an hour. Then we come back and we start with the starter and put in the, and it's just water, flour, starter, salt, and sugar, and that's it. So we'll see how this goes. Towel. I'm just going to put it in the oven with the light off just to get it out of the way and let it sit for about at least an hour and just let it relax, and then we work on our starter and our salt and sugar, and the process moves along. It's seems pretty good so far. When I'm mixing, I always get a little bit nervous that it's too much water and it's going to be goopy and everything, and it was, but just working it made it better. So first step done. All right, it's been an hour. It's been sitting here, it flattened out. It's kind of like, that's fine. Now the next step is to add the starter. I fed it last night around 9 o'clock. It's 8 o'clock in the morning the next day. So 11 hours, I noticed it's still kind of peaking. So what I'm gonna do here is I have some more water because it is a little bit dry. And the last time, I think I let it be too dry. So, salt, sugar, 20 grams of each, another 20 grams of water. I'm going to go ahead and put that in. Still have plenty. I ended up doing 150 grams. I want to make sure I have enough rise in it. So now, another 10, 12, 15 minutes of mixing. amazing the like I did this for about 11 minutes and it went from a wet, goopy, like disgusting mess to just a tacky, disgusting mess. So the two longest parts as far as just physical activity are done. Now I'm gonna put a wet towel over this, put this in the oven with the light on for about an hour, let it just completely rest for about an hour, and we'll see what happens the next time. If you look at it, one thing, if you watch the dessert person, Claire Saffet, she did this, she shows it at the beginning, and see how it's, well, you can see that. When you jiggle it, it's mostly a solid piece, and it just moves just a little bit. Ideally, towards the end of this process, which will be in about 4 hours from now, it's 8:30 in the morning, it'll be like this air-filled undulating mass. Hopefully, we'll see. So, covered up, in the oven with the light on for an hour. Okay, it's been about an hour. It's flat and gunky. I'm probably gonna transfer it into a smaller bowl. Maybe not, I don't know. I haven't decided yet. Anyway, let's take a look at this. I'm gonna do the first fold. It's still a big gooey mess, and there's a piece of my rag in there, no problem. It's coming together a lot nicer though. I mean, very little sticking. Elasticity is really good. I mean, feels like it should. Look, see how more jiggly it is now? It looks right. There's actually air bubbles and stuff going through. Look, there's an air bubble right here. Look at that. This is great. This is really great. That's what it should be doing. More air bubbles. It's got a lot of air and it's very jiggly now. It's it seems right. Let me get my hands wet and wash it first. Jiggly, looks good. Air bubbles. Let's go. Oh, okay. All right. Look at that. Lots of elasticity. Really great. So far, everything's looking exactly as it should. It's in there. I'm gonna cover it and with saran wrap, and then put it back in. It's been a few hours. It's 4:25 right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and put it in. It hasn't risen a whole lot. It has risen, but not a lot. It is proofing the way it should, according to what Claire said. So then, it's still jiggly, so I'm thinking it still has a lot of air in it, and that'll help it rise. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in. Got under a minute, and then I'm gonna take it out, and hopefully we've got a decent looking piece of bread. A loaf of bread, I mean. Rolls up pretty nice. Do 15 minutes to get it nice and brown. I think we're good to go. Just about a minute. It looks good. It's risen a considerable amount. The top of the bread is just over the edge of the lip of the pan, and it was about halfway in the pan. It rose just a little bit, but there was still really jiggling. There's a lot of air, so I think it's gonna be okay. Look like we're in good shape here. It smells good. It looks good. I think we're in good shape. So now it's 5:34 in the evening, and I'm going to let it sit, let it cool. All right, gave it a few hours. It's 8:30 in the evening now. Looks good. I don't know how well the light's really bright, but the crumb looks pretty good. There's like a lot of air holes, which is good. I have Eleni on the other hand. There's her hand right there, waiting for her piece of bread. Tastes right. Feels good. It was very damp, so it still feels a bit moist. But
it's a little sticky. Tastes good.
I think sitting in the bag will dry it out a bit more. It probably could have used another minute or two cooking in the side of the... I did it for 35 minutes at 425 inside of the cover, but I don't know.
It has a lot more holes than the last one.
Yeah, this is a way more airy. This had a lot more air in it, especially during the whole bulk fermentation. I could see stuff come out, so...
Maybe still ate the whole last, almost.
Yeah.
This
side. So... The crumb looks good. The flavor, I think, is good.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So.
I like it.
Yeah. There you go. Fourth loaf is in the books. And start working on this one.